for this episode, I spoke to Dr. Willis from the University of Oxford about his book, Algeria, Politics and Societies from the Dark Ages to the Era. What you can expect to hear about is, so the Dark Ages, President Bouteflika's presidency, and why people were upset, why there were protests in 2014, why these protests were surprising, what people protested and wanted, and what the situation is like now, among lots of other things. And I hope you enjoy the video. Why were the protests in Algeria in 2019 a surprise?
The protests in 2019 in Algeria was surprised, particularly outside of Algeria, particularly in the context that 8 years earlier in 2011, there'd been the widespread protests that became known as the Arab Spring, as we saw big popular protests sweep across the Arab world, leaving virtually no state untouched, beginning, of course, in Tunisia, then Egypt and Libya and Syria and so forth. And really, Algeria hadn't seen any significant protests. There'd been some protests, but rather small scale. And it was generally regarded that that was unlikely. After that, it was unlikely that Algeria would have protests. There was a generalized view that Algeria had come through a very bitter and bloody civil conflict in the 1990s, which meant that the population was probably a little bit still rather traumatized by those experiences and wasn't going to move into a big period of social protest and street politics. So that was the outside perception. I think inside Algeria, there was less surprise because economic problems, problems of corruption, unhappiness with the ruling regime had been mounting for some time and there'd been growing disillusionment. But I think what was surprising was the nature of protests, in the fact that they were not only enormous, there were hundreds of thousands of people came onto the streets then, but they were virtually entirely peaceful. And given Algeria's bloody past, a lot of commentators thought that if there was going to be protests, they would almost certainly be violent. And this was a big surprise, particularly for outside observers, that the protests were so peaceful.
And what were they protesting about?
In specific terms, the protests that began in February 2019 were to protest and call for an end to the sitting president, Abdelaziz Bouteflika's intent to stand for a fifth consecutive presidential term. He had already had four terms as president, and the protests were erupted after he had announced, or it had been announced, that he would stand for a fifth consecutive term. Interestingly enough, they weren't protesting against his excessive power, but the fact that he had really been rarely been seen in public in his fourth presidential term. He had a severe stroke in 2013, which meant he was unable to campaign in the 2014 presidential campaign, and he only appeared in public a few times a year thereafter. And people have said, this is not a way to run a country. He clearly isn't capable of running the country as president. We don't know who's running the country. And therefore, the idea that he runs for a fifth term is unacceptable, and he should be removed. Now, interesting enough, once within 6 weeks of the protests erupting on 2nd of April 2019, President Bouteflika did indeed succumb to the demands and he resigned as president. However, the fact the protests didn't really greet that as a big success indicates that that wasn't the real problem. The protests continued, in fact, even got even bigger because they wanted removal of the whole system that had produced President Bouteflika. So really the protests were about the broader political system and broader political setup and arrangement in Algeria, rather than specifically about President Bouteflika, who was just as seen as a symptom of the system.
And what kind of system changes did they want?
They wanted the whole political order to change. They wanted everybody, particularly in the elite leadership over the recent years, who they called the gang, to be removed and to be replaced and the whole system to be reworked.
Okay. And what happened in the Algerian Civil War?
The civil conflict of the 1990s had really grew out of an attempt to try and broaden out and pluralize the Algerian political system. In October 1988, there had been widespread rioting and unrest and protests in Algeria, mainly due to economic and social crises that had been brought on by the collapse in the international price of oil. Algeria's economy was overwhelmingly dependent on oil and gas sales. So when prices fell by 40% within the space of a year, the government revenue fell. This led to reduction of imports, job losses, and a huge economic crisis that had produced people onto the street. Now, for various reasons, the president of that time, Shadli Benjadid, decided to open up the political system and allow other political parties, previously there'd only been one legal party, to contest elections. And in these elections, it was the success of a new party, and moreover, an Islamist party called the Islamic Salvation Front, known by its French acronym Front Islamique du Salut, or FIS, F-I-S, FIS as it was called in Algeria, started to win those elections. It won them at the local and provincial level and was on the verge of taking power at the national legislative elections when there was an intervention by the existing force of the state led by senior generals that stopped the electoral process, banned the FIS, and abandoned the whole experiment at that stage with multi-party democracy. And it was out of that stopping of the route to power of the Islamists that led to the formation of armed Islamist groups to protest and to overturn this decision that led to an expanding civil conflict throughout the 1990s that pitted armed Islamist groups against the state that cost tens of thousands and even by some accounts, hundreds of thousands of lives throughout the 1990s.
Okay. What is the Hirak movement?
The Hirak movement was the name given to the protest movement that emerged in 2019. Hirak means movement in Arabic, and it was it gave itself that term as a very broad-based protest movement. It was all the people who had come out onto the streets to protest about Abdulaziz Bouteflika seeking a fifth term in office. This grew in strength and diversity as the weeks progressed. Protest movements were actually banned in the capital, Algiers. The one on the 22nd of February was really the first one that broke that. And thereafter, there were weekly protests every Friday where everybody came onto the streets. There were sub-protests every Tuesdays by students, and these spread across the country. And they involved enormous numbers of people, tens of thousands, then hundreds of thousands. And there are some estimates that at its peak, the movement across the country had brought out millions of Algerians onto the street. Now, these sort of numbers meant that it was an enormous cross-section of people, of Algerians who came onto the streets. It wasn't one particular part of the population, one particular ideological current, one particular demographic. It tended to be better educated and younger people who came onto the streets. But there were Islamists, there were leftists, there were women's rights activists, there were people from the Kabylie region of Algeria. All across the spectrum, people came out, just the sheer numbers of people who were deeply unhappy with the system. The Hirak movement as such was not very organized in terms it didn't have a leadership or a structure. It was initially organized online, and people would make contact at the weekly demonstrations, but it became a regular occurrence for well over a year with people coming onto the streets and began to adopt the idea of the Hirak, the movement that was calling for initially the departure and the end of Bouteflika's attempt to have a fifth consecutive presidential term in office, and then to call for a wide-scale reform, indeed removal of the existing political leadership in Algeria. So it didn't have an actual structure. It was more a mass movement. In that sense, it had certain similarities with the protest movements that emerged in other Arab countries and what we came to know as the Arab Spring 8 years earlier in 2011.
Okay. What political and social changes have happened in Algeria since the dark decade in the 1990s?
Right. What happened was with the conflict of the 1990s, which I mentioned earlier was a long and bloody one that cost tens of thousands, possibly hundreds of thousands of lives in Algeria. Things began to change in Algeria around the turn of the millennium as it moved from the 1990s into the 2000s. And three things happened. Perhaps most obviously was the coming to power of President Abdelaziz Bouteflika. He was elected president. He came to power in April 1999. But there were two other changes that were, I think, more profound and more important. Secondly was the change in the international price of oil that began to rise in the year 2000 substantially. And this gave the Algerian state, which had been economically more or less on its knees in the 1990s, after the crisis of the 1980s with the collapse of the international price of oil, it rose substantially. And suddenly Algeria had large amounts of wealth coming in that allowed the regime to be able to fund a lot of recovery from the civil war, reconstruction, infrastructure, housing, jobs, and made an enormous difference that really transformed a lot of aspects of Algeria, not quite as extensively as the sort of money that was coming in should have done, but it made a big difference. That changed the political scenario with the state able to do a lot more. It was able not only to do reconstruction with infrastructure and roads and buildings and houses and jobs, but it also brought a lot of people into the state and were able to subsidize people across the scale that actually made people feel much more positive towards the regime, that it was achieving things, they were receiving money. What in called in academic terms is called rent came out from the state, that people felt that their standards of living rose significantly during this period because of this, the revenues that came with the rise in the price of oil and gas. That changed things. And also you saw a significant decline in the levels of violence from the conflict of the 1990s. The violence didn't end altogether, but the levels declined significantly once you got into the new millennium. This was due to a number of factors, partly due to the price of oil change, but allowed the state to spend more and to fund the struggle better against the armed groups. But also a deal was struck with a large section of the armed groups to have an effective amnesty that brought most of the conflict and most of the armed groups in and to sign a deal. So the violence declined. So with the decline of violence, the improvement of the economic situation, and a rather more new dynamic president in the shape of Abdelaziz Bouteflika, as you got into the 2000s, a new political structure, a new political arrangement, and dispensation seemed to be emerging in Algeria in the 2000s. Of course, this was a period that then really came to an end 20 years later with the protests we were just talking about in 2019. Not only was it the end of Abdelaziz Bouteflika's presidency, which the crowds had called for, and he resigned in April 2019, exactly 20 years after he'd been elected, but also there had been the price in oil had begun to fall in 2014 significantly over time, which deprived the Algerian government of the sort of revenues that it had been used to. And the story since then has been of declining revenues and as the state beginning to increasingly run out of money. Today, it still has some of that money left, but it's rapidly running out. So that whole situation has now evolved over 20 years. There is some discussion about whether there had been discussion that with the fall of Bouteflika, and who was the architect of the process of amnesty, ending the civil conflict and reducing the violence, and the falling price of oil, but actually the peace, the social peace, might unravel in Algeria with it, and that some of the wounds and divisions that were still there from the civil conflict that had never really been discussed. There was no truth and reconciliation process in Algeria. Basically, money was given to the participants, and there was a decision that there would be a sort of a blanket amnesty and this should be forgotten about. And there was some discussion that this may come to an end. But interestingly enough, it didn't come to an end, but there was a social reaction. But what happened was that it was the people came onto the streets in peaceful protest.
And what political order was established following the 1990 election, and what struggles did they face?
Well, as I said, the three pillars came into place with President Bouteflika, expanded oil revenues, and And with the decline in violence. Now, what up until Bouteflika's come to power as president, the ruling political order had been had been much more collective and had been dominated particularly by military figures. The military have always been important and always been part of the Algerian state. They helped establish it after the independence struggle, and they were present without it. Many of Algeria's post-independence presidents were actually military officers themselves. Abdelaziz Bouteflika's direct predecessor as president, Lamine Zerouel, was a senior military officer. And that had dominated the power structures through the 1990s. The fact that there was a civil conflict with the armed Islamist groups strengthened and the role of the army brought it again even more to the fore than it had been. And what happens during Bouteflika's period is that he gradually eases out a lot of the senior military figures and to his own advantage. They are retired, they are pushed to one side, and he moves to center straight. He brings in a coterie of his own loyalists. He particularly begins to bring in business figures who are involved in the private sector and who are basically benefiting from the new contracts that are given out for infrastructure and housing and other things that are able to be paid for by the new revenues coming in with oil and gas. The exact new order that Bouteflika puts in place as he eases out the old military figures becomes rather unclear as Bouteflika's health begins to decline. His first bout of ill health is in 2005, which weakens him significantly. He'd been very active up until that point. And then he has a severe stroke, as I mentioned earlier, in 2013, that really removes him from the political arena. And this does provoke the questions and the unhappiness amongst the Algerian population with the question of who is actually running Algeria. The president, Bouteflika, despite being constitutionally the most powerful person, is clearly not in a position by being so incapacitated by the stroke that he can hardly walk or speak or talk. So who is actually running the country? And the collective leadership behind him was unclear. And a lot of Algerians came onto the streets in 2019 to demand, well, who is actually running our country? It's not exactly clear the order was put in place. There was a lot of unhappiness that the president's brother and family seemed to be involved in running the country, given Abdelaziz Bouteflika's ill health. And that was a source of a lot of unhappiness to a lot of Algerians who said, well, we're not some dynastic monarchy. They compared themselves, it's traditionally compared themselves favorably to Morocco, which a lot of Algerians see as a rather feudalistic monarchy, and say, we're not a monarchy, we're a proud Republican state, where it's not based on family. So when the president's family, particularly his brother, had become very involved, there was a lot of suspicion about that. But the lack of clarity of the leadership in the system, it's often described as opaque, and clearly quite a collective leadership. Algeria is quite unusual in the Arab world in that politics isn't normally dominated by a single powerful individual. It's a much more collective and much more unclear structure, but arguably goes back to the liberation struggle out of which the initial Algerian regime emerged in fighting the French, had rather clandestine structures, and it was fought with a leadership that was much more collective in man. And that clearly is still continuing 50, 60 years now after independence. It seems that the structure that emerged after Bouteflika stood down is pretty much the same. The president is not a particularly powerful figure. The military are there, but the military leader of the military doesn't seem to be necessarily the dominant figure. So it's a collective leadership has now been reasserted in Algeria, a mixture of figures from both the military and the civilian old establishments.
Okay, that's all the questions I have. Is there anything else you feel that is important?
The only thing maybe to add is what happens now. The protests continued in 2019 for over a year. They were voluntarily suspended in the spring of 2020, just after they'd been going just over a year because of COVID. They were revived again in February 2021, but through a combination of state repression and again another wave of COVID, they were suspended. And it seems that the Algerian state has tried to, the old order has tried to just basically continue as it had before. And the question that now is that whether the Hirak movement will reassert itself. Algerians are certainly no more happy than they were before. They're very unhappy with the way the country is run. The economy is in a very bad state. There's still, the oil price has not risen high enough to be able to not continue running through the very now, the reserves that they'd be able to build out through the period of high prices. The leadership is quite low profile, and a lot of people are still very, very unhappy. And I think it's quite likely that some form of a Hirak will reemerge or other forms of protest because of the very dire situation in the economy and the continuing unhappiness with the population. The view is that nothing has really changed. Bouteflika stood down. Some of the people in his regime have now been removed and been put in prison, but the fundamental system is still in place.
Okay. It was really nice hearing what you had to say. Thank you so much for making the time to talk to me.
Oh, you're very welcome.
Here's a quick recap. So we learned about why the protests in 2014 were unexpected to people outside of Algeria, why people in Algeria were upset about their president running for a fourth term, and the current situation. I'd like to hear your thoughts on this. If you have any additional information, please leave it in the comments down below. And thank you for watching.